another visitor. Stay a while. Stay forever.
Alright guys, welcome back to another edition of Toy of Insanity, and this is episode 28. And today we're going to take a look at, finally, I've been holding off on this forever, the VOTC and VTSC collection. What the heck is that? That's a Vintage Original Trilogy Collection and the Vintage The Saga Collection. The VOTC collection, that is the Vintage Original Trilogy Collection, came out in 2004. And as you can see in front of me, you have Luke Skywalker, Princess Leia, Han Solo, and Ben Kenobi. And when I first found out about these, and I don't know what part of 2004, maybe it was late 2003, found out about them, I almost flipped out because, you know, as you can see, they're on vintage card backs. And, you know, some of you might that don't know might be thinking, well, is this part of the vintage collection that's out right now? No, it's not. It's not. This is what kickstarted the whole thing. This line is what took Star Wars figures that it was at the time to a whole different level, which was better sculpts, you know, soft goods that are out of control, you know, more articulation. And eventually we even got the Vintage Collection. But anyway, what we're going to start with here is the original Trilogy Collection, the VOTC line. So in 2004, they came out with this half of it, and you got the first four figures, Luke Skywalker, again, Princess Leia, Han Solo, and Ben Kenobi. And they all come in this star case. And there's Luke Skywalker. And I love him. He's freaking awesome. They did a very good job on these guys. And on the back, just like the other Vintage Collection, talks about the figure when it first came out. Of course, with Kenner, who shows you the head there. Got this for Slay. And of course, Han Solo. And I gotta tell you, I still love these to this day. Even though it's gonna be almost 10 years coming up. It's 2012, middle of the year. Almost 10 years to when these guys came out. And they're really awesome. Oh, should have shown you the back. And of course, and again, Obi-Wan Kenobi. And believe it or not, I bought these up in Canada. I was on vacation. And they weren't here. So you know what? It was August or July when I picked these up. And they weren't available anywhere around here. Now I'm thinking about it. Couldn't find them anywhere. Let me show you real quick, because I forgot to show you the back of Leia. So these probably really hit in about fall of 04. Sounds about right. So anyway, that's the first wave that came out. And they did two more waves in the Trilogy Collection, and here we go, I'll show you those other two. Okay, next up is Darth Vader, C-3PO, Yoda, and Lando Calrissian. This is the second wave of the VOTC Vintage Original Trilogy Collection. And this is the Darth Vader that just took me by surprise, and I about flipped out when I got this guy. Too badass. Of course, they've done a few since then. But he's still one of my favorites, for sure. And he's been redone many times. Yes, we'll buy him. Right. And C-3PO. And I still like this C-3PO much better than C-3PO that they did for the Vintage Collection. That one has just got some issues. I don't know why they made him like that they did. They have no idea, but they did. So yeah. And third to go. Third up. Master Yoda. They did a damn good job on these guys. I'm telling you, this is what revolutionized the Star Wars figures right here. Every Star Wars collection flipped out when they came out with these. Did away with doing all the figures with all plastic. Better articulation, better sculpts, and soft goods, folks. What can you say? There it is. Wave 2 of the VOTC line comes Wave 3. Okay, here's Wave 3 of the VOTC line, and we have Chewbacca, Boba Fett, R2-D2, and a Stormtrooper. And here's Chewie. Did a great job. This was the best Chewie that they did at the time, of course. Highly praised line. Again, Lobayo and the old Kenner figure. Next is the Boba Fett that blew all the rest away. These folks, it's on Return of the Jedi card. And it's Return of the Jedi Boba Fett, a little bit different from Empire. And I reviewed him before in the past. But hey, let's keep the clutch together here. Original Kenner Boba Fett. Next is R2-D2. Classic card. And this was a bitchin' R2-D2, I have to say. Really good. Still love them. Of course, they made 10,000 R2s. This will be my favorite. And showing the original. Last up for Wave 3 of the VOTC line. Stormtrooper, still one of the best. Sorry, folks. You know, if you have the time, the money to collect these guys, do it. Go on eBay and you can find them. They go roughly, I want to say average $40-ish. No, some are a little bit less, I apologize. Luke, I know, and Leia, the first book especially, is the most expensive. There you have it. There is the VOTC line, the Vintage Original Trilogy Collection that came out in 2004. And here is its counterpart that also came out in 2004. Okay, so not only did they do the Vintage OTC line with the 3 3/4 inch figures, they also did them with 12 inch figures. We're told copies, like, oh, the box art at least was the copies of what they did back in 1978 to about, what was it, 1980? God, I reviewed them, I don't even remember anymore. But, and they only did three figures, if I remember. Oh, I'm sorry, four. They did four figures. They did Luke Skywalker. As you can see here, he's in the original packaging that Kenner did. It has this outer box to protect it. And the actual doll itself is actually very, very cool. Like I said, they haven't done it again since. I wish they would do a few more just for the heck of it. Not too many, because it kind of ruins it. But yeah. So you open the packaging, and then the inside is the actual box that the figure sits in, just like it did back in the day. And then it shows on back, a little bio, but does not show the original boxed 12-inch figure from back in 78. But that's okay. You guys go back to the episode that I reviewed these, and I'm sorry, I don't remember which episode it was. It's been a few of them back. And you can see all the original 12-inch figures that Kenner did. Okay, so there is Luke. Get a little closer up. Luke Skywalker. Right on. All right, next up is Stormtrooper. Again, the same box art with the outer shell that Hasbro did to protect it. And I'd say they did a damn good job. Very cool 12-inch Stormtrooper. And again, showing the back, but not showing an original Kenner 12-inch figure, 12-inch doll, 12-inch Stormtrooper, whatever you want to call it, okay? All right, next up, and we're going to get two shots of this guy. This is Boba Fett. Boba Fett, the 12-inch, the original Kenner one, is definitely badass. As you can probably remember, if you've seen my last episode or last review I did, my last one, but when I did review these guys, yeah, I have one of these original in this box. So this is actually quite cool to have if you want an original Boba Fett. It's very, very, very cool to have. Did a good job on him. Back's the same thing. Not showing the original Kenner. I don't know. Okay, like I said, Boba Fett twice. Let's do it. Boba Fett again. And this time he's in a blue suit. There is a picture of Boba Fett back when Star Wars had come out. And I don't know if it was a picture taken before Star Wars or probably after, I'm sure is when it was. Yeah, I'm sorry, what am I thinking? It was taken after Star Wars had come out, before Empire Strikes Back, when he was being basically figured out how he was going to look. And there was that time when he was going to be white, and everybody's got that Boba Fett, that mail-away Boba Fett you can get right now online. You can't really, I don't think you can send away from it anymore, but it's the white prototype Boba Fett. But then he did become blue after that, and this is the blue Boba Fett before he came green. Boba Fett. And this Boba Fett, when it came out in 2004, he was very hard to come by because they didn't make a whole lot of them, or they just didn't box too many in one case. The same backer as usual. Now, I'm going to have to pull back on the camera for his last one. This here is, oh, this is the man himself, Chewbacca. The huge box. Just like the original, same artwork. This figure, this doll, came out to KB Toys exclusively in 2004. Actually, maybe 2005. I never researched it, so now I'm thinking about it. I think it was a little bit delayed, actually. And it might have come out late in 2004. But only at KB Toys you can get it. It's a huge box, takes up a lot of space. Look like I have a giant box to keep it stored in. So, a little shot on him without any glare. It's going to be hard today, folks. Very difficult. There he is. Chewie. And his bowcaster. Yep. And in the back. Give himself. Not the original. Alright, so stay tuned now for VTS collection. VTSC! Jeez. VTSC. Good lord. Stand by. Okay, guys, so here is the first wave of the VTSC collection. Vintage, the Saga collection. Trying to get this right, because, you know, try saying it fast. I dare you. So anyway, so up first is the first wave. They only did two waves of these, and these came out in 2006 to cap off this whole kickoff on these new badass Star Wars figures. So first off we have here is Luke Skywalker in his X-Wing pylon outfit. See, side of the collection. Shows the original Kenner on the back. A little bio. Next up is the ever living Sand People from Tusken Raider. Is Greedo. Who shot first? Greedo or Han? It's Han. Han shot first, guys. I'm sorry. Dead. Boom. Greedo back in the day. And next up is Biker Scout from Jedi. That's awesome. Really awesome, yes. Did a damn good job on him. And last up for the first wave. Bam. It's Hoth, his indoor gear. Hoth. Han. Jeez. Alright. Get it right. Very good job. Love this figure. And again, there he is in his real Kenner attire. Now, what's this, you say? It is a mail-away exclusive for a figure. It's a George Lucas figure dressed in as a stormtrooper. Ooh, what does he look like? He looks like this. Yeah, so you can go online and you can purchase him. I think right now he's roughly around $80 average-ish. Give or take some cash. But he's a cool figure if you like it. He's George Lucas. George Lucas. So I don't know. I think I would have rather than done one with a different head, but it is just a tribute to George Lucas, so that's all it is. So cool and great. It's George. Fantastic. And no, he was not the original Kenner Hasbro or Kenner figure. Sorry. So anyway, so there you go, guys. There is Wave 1 of the VTSC Vintage The Saga Collection. Here comes Wave 2. Okay, and last up we have is the second wave of the VTSC Vintage The Saga Collection that came out in 2006. And we have Luke Skywalker and his Bespin Fatigues, the Imperial Snow Trooper. Don't drink, folks. Bad for you. IG-88's Bounty Hunter Bosk, and we have Han Solo. Woohoo! All right, and he's in his Hoth outfit. So here we go. Luke Skywalker. Yes. Bespin Fatigues. Yeah. And we have the Imperial Snowtrooper. And you know what? When this guy came out, I about flipped out. It was badass. Did a great job on him. Yeah, that's right, folks. And next up is IG-88. Finally, a good IG-88. I love my vintage Kenner figures, but he just was not cool back in the day. This one is really, really nice. Did a good job. Yep. There he is. Back in his olden days. Alright, and again, this Bosk. Oh man. No disintegrations, Darth Vader said to Boba Fett as Bosk stood on going, "Damn it, I wanted to do that." Sorry. Did a fantastic job. Yes. Can you imagine 1978 getting figures like this? Yeah, right. 1980. Okay. And we have Han Solo in his Hoth outfit. And really cool. Really, really, really cool. And there's a good old Kenner in the back there. And lo and behold, they actually did one more figure for the second series, second wave of the VTSC collection. And just didn't fit on here. They did six for some reason on the last wave. Princess Leia Organa in her combat poncho. Yeah. So, there you go. And she's cool. Soft goods, you know. Love it. There she is back in the day. So, yeah. So, you may be asking yourself, hey, what's that? Another sticker again. This sticker was for a special offer again for six exclusive vintage figure coins in a custom design box plus a 2007 International Toy Fair coin. Seven coins in all. Well, I didn't send away for them because they weren't action figures, so I didn't send away in care. So, woohoo! So there you go. Okay, guys, anyway, thanks as always for watching. This one was a little bit longer than usual, and I appreciate it. As always, subscribe to join it, whatever it says there on the Toy Room Insanity Facebook page. Go to my YouTube page called Count Stakus and subscribe and see all my Toy Room of Insanity videos and other weird things that I do on there. So anyway, have a great one, have a good day, have a good year, have a good summer, barbecue, and drink lots of beer. All right, guys, have a good one. Thank you. Spider-Man. Where are you coming from, Spider-Man? Nobody knows who you are.